In this lesson, we will talk about nominal sentences or jumla ismiya. As we've said before, with a murakkab or a compound, a partial thought is expressed, whereas with a sentence, a complete thought is expressed. If we have a sentence which starts with a noun, which is ism in Arabic, then this is called a nominal sentence or a jumla ismiya. With a nominal sentence or jumla ismiya, there are two major parts. One part is the subject or mubtada, and the other part is the predicate or khabar. The khabar basically is information about the subject or mubtada. The way a nominal sentence or a jumla ismiya is created is that the subject is generally expressed as a proper noun, whereas the khabar or predicate is generally expressed as a common noun. Now, here is an example. If we want to say the masjid is spacious, then notice here the masjid is the subject and is spacious is the predicate or the khabar. The masjid needs to be expressed as a proper noun. That's why we say al-masjidu. And then the fact that it is spacious, this needs to be expressed as a common noun. So we say wasi'un. Wasi'un means spacious. This becomes a sentence. The masjid is spacious. If we said al-masjidu al-wasi'u, in other words, we also had an al or a proper noun associated with wasi, then the translation would be the spacious masjid. So that would be a compound. If we wanted to say a spacious masjid, then we would say masjidun wasi'un. So notice, with a sentence, the subject is in a proper noun form and the predicate or khabar is expressed as a common noun. The subject and predicate generally match in terms of number. So typically, if the subject is singular, then the predicate will also be singular. The subject and predicate generally match in terms of gender. But there is an important exception. If the subject is the plural of something other than human, angels, or jinn, in other words, the subject is the plural of a non-intelligent entity, then the predicate could be female singular. We saw this earlier with murakkab tawsifi, and we see that again over here. Now, let's look at some examples. Al-azabu shadidun. So this is actually a regular scenario. We have a statement which is the punishment is severe. The punishment is the subject. Severe is the predicate. The subject needs to be expressed as a proper noun. And you'll notice that over here we have al-azabu, the azab or the punishment. Shadidun means severe. Since this is the khabar or the predicate, it's expressed in common noun form. And we know that because we see the tanween over here. Next we have al-qulubu mutma'innatun. Here the subject is qulub, and qulub is the plural of something that's not intelligent. Al-qulub means the hearts. Since this is the plural of something that's not intelligent, the predicate needs to be female singular, and that's exactly what we have. The translation of this sentence is the hearts are satisfied or the hearts are contented. The subject, which is qulub or hearts, is non-intelligent and plural. So the adjective is singular feminine.